welcome to Vanilla TV for the Nations Cup Grand Final. In the blue corner is Germany, in the red corner is Sweden. I'm Scully, with me is Rinter, and Mia is my co-caster. Mia, take us away.
Right, so I'm watching Riv for this mid-fight, and he's gone off very aggressive into the enemy choke, whereas Brago has stuck by the big door. He's getting a lot of pressure into him right now. He's nearly jumping onto the boy. He takes down two nuts, Feven and Riv, although a lot of Sweden? Yeah. Germany also go down as well, and right now we're seeing Zebesai and Wolters up against Ips and Brago, so this will be a very interesting 2-on-2 here.
Gonna be Wolters, they're trying to take on Ips. Can he do much there? He's gonna get focused down. So Germany win the first round there, which does help absolutely fantastically for them. They are gonna get the advantage, but also both medics went down, and am I seeing any crit streak for them? No crit streak for either of them, which is interesting. Trying to play it safe at the moment. First mid, first not map, sorry, I apologize for that twist, but Sweden do have a little bit of a grace here that they're up quicker. They're all together, but now comes the aggression from the Germans right there. This is what they want. Don't go in. They take Bashko's, take it down. Soldier bomb is going to get focused up. Brigo takes the other side, and there goes Hicks as well. So both soldiers are down for Sweden right there, and they do take the medic. No, they don't take the medic. It's going to be one-on-one. Button finally gets taken out. Sweden back in this right there. What can Riv do? Sorry, is the scout behind his Beaver? I'm not sure he can do much, but he's kind of trying to.
Yeah, I'm looking at Gear, and Gear's in trouble right now. He's sort of stuck behind the enemy, and he's getting pressured by a scout right now. He's getting so low, and he does finally get taken down. Bray goes down as well. They managed to take this point because Fun goes down, and this means that Sweden here have heals. They have an 100% Uber advantage. They should be able to get mid for free, though I don't think Germany are going to let them have this easy.
No, I don't think they are, but at the same time, what can they do? All they can do is have Brigo spamming in. If anything, they can make it so they force the Uber. They don't want to get this for free, and Riv goes down straight away. So that actually stopped any push. Sweden's actually lost his push. Now comes the Uber exchange. They've been forced out with the Uber. They take down a couple, but there's the Uber force that Germany were going for. They've made the Uber force, and even if they just back off now, just Gear and Fun alive, and it's going to be those two up. But Fun's got 50%, and Two Nuts has got 20%. It's not even 20 yet. So the advantage is back in the Germans' side, and is that Bash with a sniper rifle? It is.
Ooh, this will be really interesting, because he's obviously looking to take some heads here, although his team have Uber advantage now, but he obviously didn't know that when he switched over. You can see that Fun there is slowly coming up to 100% he's building with Ips at the top.
Yeah, I like the idea of actually going sniper, even if you do have the advantage. There's not much you can do at the moment. You're out of position, you didn't have the numbers advantage, so picking up a pit class could just really help you at the time. He's trying to peek around, trying to get something, looks for something, tries to miss a head, misses the headshot onto Riv. So now they know the sniper is definitely in play. They've called the sniper. He will start and do something, but you can see that at the same time, you've got the medic and the two soldiers there for Germany in the big door with the sniper. So if the soldiers try and go aggressive, then they're going to hiccup the counter, couple spam from the rocket, and the Germans are in great position right now. Sweden can't really push on this.
No, they can't. The Germans are playing it fairly defensive right now. They're holding by the big door, and you've got Fascist sniper rifle watching that whole big door. Although Sweden are giving it a fair shot, and finally, I think they're peeking in. Definitely, they have had to pop early because of that sniper.
Can they do anything with this? The Uber has been shared, but the Uber for the Germans haven't. And in fact, because of that, they've had no choice. They've had to go back the Germans. Watch the re-push coming in. Not going to get much if there is some action on the flank there. Well, it's a choke, really, not the flank. 3-on-3 at the moment as Germany tries to take the point because Two Nuts is out of position. Two Nuts and Riv, what can they do right now? They're going to try and focus down. Soldier bomb straight onto Two Nuts. He gets taken down. Riv can't do much. A headshot onto Wolters. And Germany there do capitalize on the out positioning there and will take this. They're going to take the mid. Might be able to walk forward and take second, yes.
Yeah, they should be able to, with Sweden only being two up. They only just got some respawns. There's, who's that in forward spawn? That is Beaven there, gone sniper in forward spawn. Let's see if he can actually get anything right now.
He's looking for something. The beam's been broken because they know he's there, so he's going to have to yeah, he's gone back to bait. Smart play there, tried to look for something, wasn't there, but now it's 5-on-5. The advantage for the Ubers in the Germans' favour. Sweden know this, and they're going to just play back and hold back as much as they can. Well, actually, I think they're up the top. They are, and it's crit screen. I did not see that change to crit screen. So they're looking for a play right now, but they could be wasting it because of the fact that, yeah, here we go. They're out of position, and now the Germans can push on to laugh with an Uber. A Two Nuts has got nothing. Don't know why they've gone crit screen again.
Yeah, well, that, I guess it was the only way of...
You broke up there.
That was the only way that they could try aggressively get lost. And right now, Tunuts has 100% crit scoop. Although that Uber has been popped through by Shuttle, it is popped there onto Zebicide. Zebicide takes down Guillaume, that first one. Can he get anyone else? Yes, he takes down Brago with the shotgun right now. And Germany are only three up at the moment. Funt is running for his life back to the enemy choke.
Yeah, good play there. They actually played nicely, nice and safe as per usual. Go back in. Don't let yourself die to an Uber. Get the crit screen rolling, it rocked and rolled. They got a couple kills from that, stopped everything. And like the old Monica Bite says, you use a crit screen to gain an advantage. And right now, the advantage is in the Swedes' favor. It's a 30% advantage. They're going to need that right now. They are looking. Ips needs to make a play. He's not exactly been making many plays at the moment. What can he do? Look, that's Gear actually looking for a move right there. Not much they can do. Trying to look for the medic point. Does force the crit screen as the scout goes onto the point. It's a bait. The scout is going to capture it because they've not got players on. That was Gear going around the corner. It's going to be 1-0 to the jump.
Oh man, that right there, that was all Gear. Just going around the corner. That was a fantastic play there. I have a feeling that Sweden probably shouldn't have bunched up in the top right like that. That definitely was for the best.
Yeah, let's just go. I'm just watching Gear as we go into another. Gotta go into the mid fight here. I say, what has the Swedes got to offer for this? Well, right now, not much. They want to try and get onto the high ground as soon as they can. It's worked for them, but now comes the aggression from the soldiers. This is actually working a lot better for the Germans right now. They take down Zebicide and Walter. They lose Ips as well, but Fun goes down for the German. Tunuts, Bibben, and Vibben against Gear, Stefan, and Breaker. They're low, the Germans. They surely won't be able to stay in for this, but they know they need to make a play on this to stop Tunuts with that Uber.
Yeah, and Tunuts is getting...
He's getting focused now.
Yeah, he's getting a heck of a lot of pressure right now. He's sitting so low right now, 60%. But they finally, Beaven and Rib, do my shoe take off Gearbreak, who is doing most of the damage. Although there's a scout in, and that's a fantastic air pipe there by Rib right onto Stefan.
Fantastic right there. It was a bit of a late play there for them. I was expecting a lot of aggression. Lot of aggression coming out there by the Swedes. Didn't happen, and the Germans had all the early aggression, but they did compose themselves, kept it going right now. They've got the Uber, they don't want to waste it. Now comes the reason to use a sniper rifle. But look at this, they blocked him in straight away. There's no way they can go. The only way they can go is what I call Epsilon, which is the top balcony. It's an old hold that the old Epsilon used to do. Can't even do that. Bash misses the shot again, and you've got half the team for Sweden in the lobby area, getting ready to go, and they've got to go now because it's 56 left on there. Here comes the scout rush straight away for the Swedes.
Yeah, there's so much capture time onto the point right now, and Braga has only just respawned. That is not enough. It did not respawn in time. That was really good, them pushing while the demo man was down. That is actually bringing it down to 1-1 with how much time is left on the clock? 22 minutes.
Textbook push there. It's something I talk about usually with some of the pushes. There is a pause. Yep, there's a pause. Just want to say, that was a textbook pushing with the scout rush. You send them up forward, you bully them back into their spawn, and at that same time, you get someone on the top, on the point. It was something that when we watched the Division 1 playoff the other day, they did not do. That is how you want to do a scout rush Uber. You want to do that. You want to do what I call the bullying. So that's basically something, with Season 60 coming up for you players up there, just watch that, and just to see exactly, you know, just how they do it, how the pros do it.
Yeah, definitely. So, this is very, very close, Scully. Who have you seen who's been doing quite a lot of work recently?
Not many of us keep a lot of the time out on it, but Gear has been doing a lot. Beben as well doing some stuff. He had a bit of a solo play, getting a couple kills. But, I mean, the players that are slacking right now, Ips, I know you're a Roma, but 5 points, not exactly doing a lot of suicide. He's doing suiciding, but suiciding. And getting nothing for it.
Actually, Ips's pocket. He's just overextending.
Really?
Yep.
See, when I see a soldier with that low points, I immediately say to myself, okay, he's playing the roaming role, and he may not get a lot of points, but even still, 5 points, he's being outscored by hit. That's going to be a little bit embarrassing. But, with this pause, if you are late to the party, we have the Humble Bundle being given away as a prize. We got two of them, and the first one's being given away in this map, which basically all you have to do is go to our Facebook, facebook.com/VanillaTVorg, and on today's post for the game, post who you think is going to be the top scorer for the team that isn't a medic. So don't say Tunuts and don't say Fun, say anybody else out the 10. Who do you think is going to be the top scorer? And also, how many points do you think they're going to get? Because that could be a tiebreaker. So do go on there. The prize is the Humble Bundle. I'm not sure what version we have to give away today, but I know it is a Humble Bundle. Still winning on the pause. Not exactly sure what the pause is for.
I don't know. I'm guessing it's some sort of player connection, although I'm looking at the scoreboard and pings do look fine.
Pings look fine. I think it's well, it's a neutral server, so it's not actually going to cause any issue with ping issues. I'm guessing someone's DC'd.
Yeah, possibly. We do have a bit of a delay.
Bit of a delay, so... why we are here. Season 16 starting, you know? Did you know that, Mia?
Yeah, I'm very excited. Definitely.
I'm excited just because it's Season 16. And as per usual, after Summerland, there's whole new roster shakeups. The silly season's over in Tier 2. New teams have been formed, old teams have been remade and reformed and traded players and players have been bought for hats and keys and scrap metal. So, it's going to be interesting to see. I know there is a game, I think we're going to actually do a lot of Division 1 as well this season, because basically everything including the kitchen sink is stacked this year. When you look at like Division 1 team, even Division 2's kind of stacked as well, some great players.
Yeah.
It's going to be a great season. The question is, can someone actually finally beat Epsilon? Bites team,
honestly...
I'm looking at you.
don't put too much pressure on him.
Why
but
not?
He's a new team. Oh yeah, it's true. But I'm not going to lie, Epsilon are looking pretty darn strong again. I think most of the fight's going to be from, you know, for spot 2, definitely. There's so many contenders for that. I think, like, Team Infused have a chance, although I have actually seen that a fake TCM did beat them in a few scrims, although they did lose on the Metalworks Cup. So.
Yeah, I didn't see the Metalworks Cup. I was actually under the weather, so to speak, so I actually missed that. I did hear that they did win the Metalworks, is that right?
Yes, they did.
Yeah, I didn't have a chance to see the Metalworks Cup. I must apologise. But it's nice that the big teams came out just to try that map. It's going to be interesting. Once again, another season with a new map. That isn't one that the community is going to cry about. Yes, shots fired, I don't care. that's actually going to be interesting to see. I tried to put the Facebook link in the Twitch chat, and... it gave me deleted link. I don't know why. I want to cry.
Yeah, but it shouldn't be too hard. It's vanillatv.org on Facebook. Explain to me what games are in the Humble Bundle again, Scully?
I'm not 100% sure myself. It was something, I've got to be absolutely honest, it was something that Byte has all the information for. so don't worry, we will give you the codes when we finish, when the game's over. If you went on Facebook, we will give you the codes via a Facebook message. For the other one, it will probably be via Steam or something like that. We'll let you know the other one. If you are upset that you don't win the first one, there is another chance, and it will not be on Facebook, because I know some people don't like Facebook, but, you know, we like to keep it fair for everybody.
Yeah, that should be coming later.
Yeah, still trying to work out what this is all about. Not heard anything about the pause from anybody at the moment.
Yeah. So I'm actually looking at the season 15 tables, and I'm looking at Division 2, and the lot of teams that I would have rated as, like, you know, low Division 1. Like, I don't know why it looks so much more interesting than last season.
I think it's all down to the summer hype over, you know, some Milan's. It's a common scene. As much as I don't want it to sound horrible, it's a common scene that after Summerland, people get their motivation back to play, and to get their motivation back, they play in the winter league. Which, with no fault of anybody, sometimes a lot of commitments happen in winter, so it's really hard. Funny enough, all my commitments happen in winter. Whoop-de-doo. So, it's hard to get yourself back in winter. But you've got that thrill, you've got that thrive to play again, which is great to see. It's like we saw last when Epsilon made the super team. It was just such a thrive that these guys wanted to get together and make something. And look what happened. Now we've made the most strongest team ever in TF2, possibly. And there's probably no way of stopping them.
Yeah, they are definitely going to be something to watch next season. Now, I do believe on Thursday we have TCM versus... was it Roberto on Thursday? So be sure to tune in for that as well while we're talking about matches.
Yeah, while we're talking about matches. Actually, I can't, off the top of my head, I can't remember the Premiership table. I thought we might as well just go over the Season 16 while we are waiting. Epsilon, of course, are in there. Bite's team, which I love this. I just love what he's done. Let's call it TCM. Yeah, you're not that TCM, but TCM. That's going to be fun to see. Other teams include The Last Resort, which is great to see TLR back supporting a Premiership team. Basically, actually, some of the it used to be in the old Last Resort before they folded. So, Evil Move. I think Kyler's playing for them now as well.
Yeah, it's nice to see Cyber back. He did take quite a long break, and he was a pretty amazing demo man.
You look about it, Traxantic, Donut, Evil Moon, Cyber, Kyler, Kalo and Heist. Just a great old school lineup for me. It's just something we haven't seen for a couple of seasons. That's going to be good to see. Infused are back as well. Not entirely sure who they've got this year for them. It looks like it's basically the same team that they've had, which is fair enough.
Zebesai on scout this time. He's replaced what was left of Tavik. Tavik, of course, is now backup for Did I Stutter, who are now turning a bit more into Yo-Yo Tech.
Whoa, did you go there?
What? No, I liked Yo-Yo Tech.
I wouldn't call them Yo-Yo Tech, but fair enough.
Well, their roster's turning a bit like into the old Yo-Yo Tech after they picked up Hat and Tamik. And still got the sucker. But he's now inactive, of course. And I think they picked up Salt from... Who did he play for last season?
I don't remember.
I think it was the Finns, wasn't it? Vinland / 90 degrees? No. No, it wasn't.
Pass, I can't remember. Did I Stutter's in Division 1 this year, which is great to see. Back to the Premier, though. We got halfway through. Roberto and Deserto. That's going to be something that's really going to annoy me. I'm just going to say right now, when Roberto and Deserto play, I'm not actually going to enjoy it. I'm just going to be calling each team wrong. That's two teams that have basically been around for a while. Deserto's an old org that used to have a couple Prem teams drop. And then when you look at it now, it is basically just an awesome lineup. Hildreth, Furbo, Boulay, Sheepy as well, Zoo, Sideshow's there as well, and Shifty. And also I think Rinter's on their team as well. I think she's a backup because, you know, we handcuff her to the computer so she streams for us.
Yeah, as for Roberto, they have... I don't have the roster yet, but I do believe one of our favourite streamers, Huey, is on there, isn't he?
I did hear that he's actually playing for them right within this year. That's also, to me, feels like an old lineup. You look at some of those players, Efug and Stark playing there with Huey. You got Rising in there as well. Bar is the medic, a guy which I've not seen before. So that's going to be interesting to see. But it's a team that has talent from before. So I'm pretty sure they'll be able to do stuff. And they did win Division 1 last season. So that's going to be interesting to see. And then there's these two teams which I think look weird. The Impracticable Project.
Impractical Project. That is Solar. Well, that was the old Solar, wasn't it?
Yes, it's the old Solar, which kind of looks like the same Solar. But with Hicks added on, QNX, Rib coming in, Little Cedar. It's got a Scandinavian feel to it. And then, Cause We Can.
That's RLM.
It's Revolution Lameda again. These teams love to change their names.
Actually, RLM are getting sponsored. That's why they changed it. They're getting sponsored by the Cause We Can German community.
Fantastic. I mean, when you look at their lineup, I mean, I'm gonna be honest. I don't think it's going to be a half table this year, where basically you've got half the players fighting for the playoffs and the other half playing for something else. So, if that makes sense, like the bottom half of, you know, there's actually going to be quite a tight grouping. If it's anything to go with the last season we saw, it could be quite an interesting fight for that final fourth spot in the playoffs.
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be pretty close between the both teams. I don't actually, for once, like, have a good clue of who's going to end up in the top four.
Apparently, Zebesai and Bash timed out.
For a very long time.
But one's German, one's Swedish. That makes no sense.
Well, at least we can assume that it's not DDoS now.
I've got to admit, if anybody's like watching on the stream, our STV right now is actually quite interesting because everybody is now acting like the game's still going. And I've got to admit, STV chat's absolutely fantastic right now. If you've never gone to an STV to watch it, it's absolutely fantastic to watch. These guys are just going on, pretending they're watching a game and commentating on it. It's like, oh my god, that air shot from Zebesai! Wow, the Ubersaw from Fun! Rib! Oh, Rib, what a pipe! It's fantastic to see. Oh, it's brilliant to see. We are still waiting for them. But apparently, they're actually calling him in real life.
They're actually calling the players in real life.
Apparently, yeah.
I once was in Mumble with Marilyn at about 6 a.m. my time, and he called Zebesai when it was 7 a.m. Zebesai's time, and woke him up, and it was pretty amusing. But that's just an odd story on the side.
No story on the side right here. I'm loving some of the people right now with their opinions on who they think is going to do it. A couple of people wanting Brager, a couple of people saying Stefan. Just remember, it is on the match post for today. As much as we like it on the wall, it is for the match post on today, ladies and gentlemen. I guess we may if it's right, but we don't want a whole spam on our wall. It's mainly if you do it to the match match post for today. Match post, the Facebook post.
Status.
What do they call it nowadays?
The status post.
A status. Yeah. I could say that in as much American as I could, and it would still sound horrible. I don't know how we kill time for a pause. I've got to admit.
Yeah, no, it is taking an inordinate amount of time. Usually pauses don't last longer than 5 or 10 minutes, and I think we're pushing 15 at the moment.
Yeah, I think what we're going to do, because we have no clue what the hell's going on, and I think Rinter kind of had, I think Rinter's kind of got ideas on them. I think what we're going to do is we will go to music. Let's go for music, because apparently they're doing a 10 minute wait, because there are connection issues. If you're looking on Twitch chat, or anybody who's not looking at Twitch chat, there's been no success with the connection. They're going to either wait and either reschedule or use a Merc, but I don't think they're allowed to use a Merc because of the fact that it's the Nations Cup. So it's 1-1, and I think the best thing to do is to go to music. So Rinter, if you're ready with that button, music DJ, please, Rinter, take us away.
Created the other
in the game. So we will get a bit of ice skating right now. But again, we do have Germany in the blue and Sweden here in the red. And right now you can see that Germany have gone up for the normal rollout right now. They're getting a lot of pressure. Beaven, they're getting taken down by a lot of spam from Gear. And also the other scout from Sweden, that's Walters, going down as well. And it looks like Sweden just have to back out of this and give this mid to Germany to preserve their Uber.
It's kind of hard to see with a broken HUD. I have no idea how long this HUD's going to be broken for. But the Germans are really aggressive right now. They're focusing down. This is almost like typical Epsilon. The fact that mid's not even captured and they're almost onto last. Fantastic just to see. So there they go. They've managed to capture second. They're all ready for this. I'm guessing my HUD's broken. It's 100% versus 100%. It is. There's a sniper coming out, which is Walters. But I'm pretty sure it's going to be Uber cut in straight away.
Yeah, definitely. I'm reconnecting this server right now, but okay, it looks like both Ubers have finally faded right now, and it's one down for each team. Actually, two nuts there going down to Stefan there, getting into his face, and this could mean that Germany have a window to push here as long as Gear doesn't go down.
And another pawn.
Scully, are you okay?
That was a bit
of a witch cackle you had going on there.
I am broken.
So, unfortunately there is another pause, so there is more, you know, connection issues with players. So you will have to bear with us for a bit.
I'm sorry for the laughing. I'm just looking at Twitch chat right now. It's just a lot of laughing. I'm really just like, okay, ladies and gentlemen, story time with Scully. When you go to a soccer game, the day before you cast the grand final, for the love of God, make sure it's a game where you win, so you don't shout at the referee. That's all I'm saying. My throat is destroyed, my head is killing. But damn, it was a good soccer game despite we lost. But now I gotta cast this. Okay, story time with Scully's over. You can...
You're right, Scully, story time with Scully is great. Should we... Oh, wait, we have an unpause. We have a... Yeah, we had a mini unpause, like a player in or something. You bear in mind that they are a few seconds ahead of us as well, because STV does have a 90-second delay.
I love that people ask what was the game when it's like, it's something, the game that no one cares about. Is it a lead that no one should care about? But it doesn't, but anyway. This pause.
Should we try and predict what happens in the meanwhile?
Do you know, I have not done that for a while.
It's really fun.
Okay, let's have a look. So, Hicks is going to get killed by it. No, wait, no, Ips is not looking at Hicks. So, Hicks may actually get away. No, I don't know. Hicks could probably die to Ips. There we go. I'm going to predict
that. Yeah, but Ips isn't looking like at the right angle. Like right now, where Ips is looking, he would shoot a rocket into Shadow. Hicks is very low. He's on 52. But I reckon he could get a rocket off onto Ips, take him down to 188, but not do any more than that, because you can see the scouts and the demo are looking at him over there.
Oh, we know that the other side is AFK. So, there's that one out the picture. Bash, I think, also... DC, so yeah, there's Gear floating about. He'll probably die or stay freeze in a minute. I kind of just want to say this is Germany's round.
Yeah, and then like two nuts went down just there to Stefan getting into his face. So the three Swedish players are up right now with both scouts, Walters and Beaven being respawns. They don't have heals at the moment, and Hicks is going to die pretty darn soon. He has to do something amazing to try and stop this right now. As you can see, Ips is overhealed. He's almost at a full overheal and going on to the point.
Yeah, I mean, people want story time back. Like, I don't know how we can have more story time. I'm now just going to wait for Twitch chat to tell me what they want me to talk about. And it's probably going to be something that's like explicit. I don't know. Lost my virginity, you can go to hell. Right, okay. So, I want to say that we should go to music again.
But it might, like, you know, they might start again as we go to music like I did last time.
How about we go to music and Rinter keeps the game on so you can see what's happening, and if it starts moving, you can go and chat Rinter, they're live, and we can come back and start casting. How's that?
Yeah, it sounds pretty good.
Let's go to some music, Rinter. I think the best thing to do is to go to the music right now. And we're back again. There was a mini unpause, which if there's a mini unpause, it means that there's going to be someone trying to join the server, because you can't join a server when it's paused because STV is outdated type stuff. You know, it's old technology. Should be going. We've had two rounds in an hour, people. Are we ready?
Yeah,
everyone's
ready.
Everyone's saying they're ready. They move for... Okay.
This isn't what usually happens.
Here we go, oh. Back up, going straight away. Scout onto the point. Here they go, it's going to be pushing out, and it is going to be 2-1 to the German. There's the first pause. We've got to get ready for the second pause. Yes! Yes! We're back up, it's 2-1 to the German! I've never been so happy saying that, I don't know why. 2-1 to Germany right now. Twitch is going insane! What can the Germans right. do? This is crazy.
So we're onto a fourth mid fight here, and I'm watching Gears Kamimura. He's going under. He's probably going to jump up and do something. He's got another scout accompanying him right now. Fun is the first one to go down. That's no heals at all for Germany. They have to get the Swedish medic. That would be too nuts. Although you do see Fifi, Hicks, and Beeman all going down. But at the moment, Sweden will have the heals. And there's not much that he can do. He's so low at the moment. And they actually all stuck up into the enemy's choke, with Brego actually killing himself.
Oh, well done, Brego. But I think the Swedes should be able to take this. They should be able to take this point. Keep everyone alive. I'm pretty sure the Ubers are in their advantage right now. Of course it is, because Fun went down. They'll capture this. How long do they want to go? Some great play there happening for them. Even in behind their place, which is quite interesting. Didn't see what happened at Brago there. I think he was just trying to go for a kill and kind of got the kill and did a suicide. So, what does Sweden want to do right now? Well, the Germans are holding back and the Swedes aren't pushing forward. And yeah. Here comes the second port.
Well, at the moment, Sweden have an 100% Uber advantage. They had a massive advantage because Fun went down. He was like the first one to go down that mid-fight. And they're finally pushing right now, but Fun's still on 65%. And they're making a push through Big Door, whilst Germany are sitting on top right now with the height advantage. I wonder if they can delay it in time for Fun to get Uber. And Sweden, Beaven, they're taking a body shot and Hate's going down as well. So their push will definitely be paused as Fun is coming up to 100%.
Yeah, here got the soldier trying to bomb on their gear, does not get the pop there. Just get taken out from Walter. And now it looks like that the Germans, they want to be the aggressor here. They've got the Uber. I'm not sure if Tunuts has still got his Uber. He does indeed. But it looks like the Germany want to do stuff, but they're out of position. They can't. Gotta wait on this headshot hit from Zebersai? That's surely a bug. Okay. The sniper there, he does take down Bash straight away. Uber's still not been forced with the backup going on. This could force the Uber right now for them. Can they stop this spot? Yeah, they should be able to stop it. Yes, it's drawn them back though.
Yeah. I feel like Tunut's held onto his Uber for way too early. He's holding on into Trick. He should have just popped it and had someone jump Bash. And that went really kind of badly for them, considering a lot of Germany were out of position. But anyway, can now see Germany capping the point. And they do, however, have an Uber this one because Fun did pop. So now all they have to do is wait for Walters to come back. And Zebersai there going down as well. Bash is going huge for that sniper rifle.
Bash is going huge for that sniper rifle. I'm not exactly sure why my HUD is screwed up with different players and different teams. There is a crash happening and there's no pause at the moment, so they're just going to keep going for this. As the Germans will get onto this point right now. They're going to be standing on, they're going to be stacking the point, and they don't have the Uber advantage. But they do have a player advantage right now. 57-58 right now. They should be able to push straight into this right there. As they are actually going to go in for this.
I have retried into serve, and I can tell you that Hicks has actually dropped, and right now Sweden are playing with 5 people, and Germany are not letting them having a pause until after the round. You can see Basher sitting down at low lobby. He gets a body shot onto, I believe that's Beaven, but he does manage to take him down in the end. However, that I believe that's Walters there going down as well?
Yes. I believe anyway, it is. Sorry, just looking.
The Ubers are changed onto last year, and we have another pause.
Yeah,
are you okay, Scully?
I just started realizing I've made this awesome plan for about how do we do the points and just realized that we can't because there's 2 rounds, so I have to do mathematics.
And anyway, there's an unpause!
There's an unpause straight away, they're going to get into this right there. Can the Swedes hold on to this? They're going to stack the point, they're going to block everything. That's it, I can't, my head's still frozen, it's been so long since it's been unfrozen. As Tunos gets taken down, Zebersai with two, that's not Zebersai, sorry, that cannot be Zebersai. It's Bash, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Bash. Bash there going in again, 2k. If you try retrying to server. But anyway, that was a bit of a fail push into last though. However, Tunuts did go down, and this will leave Foot with an Uber advantage right now. You can see Walters there a bit overextended and does get taken down by Ipsos. He does try to make something happen, but he probably should have done it by himself there.
Yeah. Just want to say, it does say that Zebersai's playing for Sweden and Justin's playing. Just swap their names around, it looks like it's a massive STV bug. Just ignore it. If it says Justin on red, it means that it's Zebersai. If it says Zebersai on blue, it means that it's Bash. So, just ignore that. 5 versus 6 at the moment for the sweep. They are actually entitled to not pause, which is fair enough. Here they come with the scout rush straight away, trying to focus down the heavy as fast as they can. Still not taking the heavy out. They do finally take the heavy out. They should be able to stop this. There's only 3 left up there. It's going to be 3 versus 4. Got to try and stack the point. Get as many people as they can. They do get it. And that's going to be the 3-1 for the half for the jump.
Yeah, and now it's halftime at the moment. Hicks has finally joined back into the game. But with all these unpauses and stuff, it really stopped Sweden's momentum. And especially that last round when they were playing 5 versus 6. And this does mean that it's 3-1 up, although I feel that Sweden can definitely pull it back.
It's going to be interesting to see how this goes. The reason they're not pausing is you're only allowed 2 pauses or a certain time of pause. So as much as I try to deter from it, you may want to call it dickish, it's entitled to the rules. That's all I can say about that. They are trying to sort this out. Actually, maybe I can hit retry while we're waiting for this. I can hit
but yeah, I'm reading the chat right now, and apparently Zebesai, Hicks, so both soldiers for Sweden, alongside Rib having crashes and freezes, that all three of them are having issues right now. And yes, it is well within Germany's right to deny them a pause, I guess. But you would have thought for the Nations Cup they would have been a bit more gentlemanly.
I'm not going to get into that debate. just seriously, I refuse.
Yeah, I'm actually reading in chat right now, and it appears that Germany refused to reschedule for the Swedes. And you can see Ip saying, yes, we play this game tonight. Because the members don't want to reschedule.
I'm trying not to get political right now, I've got to be absolutely honest. I'm pretty sure it was a default date which Swedes were happy to play, and the Germans said, we can't, can we play Sunday? The problem we've got as well is that it's actually really hard to play because
the season starts. Yeah.
Exactly, yeah. So, I'm just trying to read the chat, also try and figure this out, but it's nice to have a HUD that works now. Yeah, HUD that works! Go me!
So anyway, I believe what's going to happen is, well, what has happened is that there is a colour change. So right now, Germany are going on red and Sweden have switched back over to blue because this is the American rule set and you do change sweaters midway through. So
change
now,
sweaters, I love that.
Yes, switch sweaters. But yes, now they're playing to 5 overall caps onto this map. So at Sweden need 4 more caps.
Germany need two. Do you know, I remember the old school rugby shirts that all the schools had. They were generic. Basically, you had different colours, but they were all the same. Where on one side, it was a blank, and on the other side, if you flip it over, it was a stripe. So if your school played a school with the same team colours, you'd have to decide which team turned their shirts inside out, so they had the white stripe on. They were the coolest things ever, because you know. Just to the fact that it would just save a lot of money for people for little schools not to buy away shirts. That's a little bit of a story time there for people. But that'd be really cool if they implemented that in TF2. Forget red versus blue. It's the planes versus the stripe.
Yeah, I remember having that in school when like it would be like blazers versus shirts or something. But anyway, I believe people are taking pee breaks right now or sorting out internet issues to ensure that the second half isn't so pausey, basically, if that were to be an adjective.
Yeah, a yellow team would people want, maybe a green team, pink. I'm making up colours right there.
Not gonna lie, I would love to see a pink team, Scully.
Yeah, I remember I actually used to play No Earth Energy. The community teams have to be colours. They're comp teams. So basically, like, I played in Super Pink. That was awesome.
Yeah, I must say that's a very manly there, Scully.
Yeah. Oh, apparently we should sub it. I kind of don't know if I can cast, and also would I have to play. No, I can't because they've lost their demo, man. I can't play demo, I'm sorry. Can you play demo?
No, I play medic in Div 4. I can't really play demo.
Yeah, Tuna's comp. I don't think Tuna. Yeah.
Ah, no, but it does look like Rib is back in and he has drone back. So right now we're sitting on 6-on-6 at the moment, so we just have to wait for teams to ready up.
Yep. I just see some rumors about default win. I hope it's just live. Can we go live? Maybe. I'm just having to look exactly what's going on. I apologize for the. So both teams say they're ready. I hear a ready up sound. Come on, no, one more ready up sound. Waiting for one more ready up sound. We apologize, guys, for this map. Yes, we have gone live. Okay, finally we've gone live. The red corner's Germany, of course. They need 2 to win, 4 to win for Sweden. The blue corner, Mia. Let's see what we can do.
All right, so now it looks like the Swedish are getting super duper aggressive right now. Both soldiers are jumping onto the point, but who's that going in? I think that's Gear and it's both doing a jump in. They tried to predict where Tunas was, but he's jumping around everywhere at the moment. That is some beautiful surfing there by Tunas. He picks up the health pack in his own chokes, and he goes back out right now to support his team, with Fun there going down as he's being chased out via Big Door.
And Fun goes down straight away. And who takes Fun down? Who takes Fun down? Is that Beben? No, it's not, actually. It's Walters. Okay, fair enough. It's Walters with the Walters pistol. Big plays there from Walters going up there. Aggression's working great for Sweden. Just a turnaround. I'll tell you what. As much as it sounds a little bit biased, you can see, you bet that they're going to be fired up right now. And this is what they want. They're going to be fired up and they want to be really aggressive. Sniper comes out for Bash. Is he going to get anything at the moment? He's not going to get anything. Has been spotted, has been called. But you know what? The Swedes decide they just want to go straight in. Seconds being captured, pardon me, seconds being captured, they just want to go right now.
Yeah, they can certainly afford to do it right now because Gear and Bash are down at the moment. Bash was getting caught out in Riverside, and they have actually popped out through Riverside at the moment. Of course, Fun does not have the Uber right now. This Fun point, that point is being sticky up right now by Demoman from underneath, although he's getting a lot of pressure. Brigger's getting pressured there by Beaven. He meat shots him, and actually you can see a medic on the point trying to get Uber Source. Both medics trying to get Uber Source. Fun there taking down two with an Uber Source.
Fun was so low and he's gonna, and he was on 96. No, you don't pause when it's like this.
Oh my god. Oh, okay. So Bash is currently on point with 10 health. He reflected a rocket. Who did he reflect it? He reflected it, a rocket into Beaven there. So
don't
it was this rocket into Beaven.
This is not good.
Now
this
we've got.
I can't predict this when it's a pause.
We have Hicks here with 28 health and Bash here with 10 health. Now Hicks, he's the roamer. He does not have a shotgun. If he shoots a rocket and Bash reflects,
right.
He could stay alive. And because he's right in front of Bash, that rocket might just hit him. If Bash misses the reflect, then Bash would die and Hicks would cap the point.
Oh my god. What we need right now is some Clint Eastwood. Good, the bad, the ugly, with the famous stare down. Was it good, the bad, the ugly? Just need some Western music right now. Some, you know, some cowboy music, because this is. If you could screenshot this, this is perfect. Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Is it gonna be the reflect of Bash? Providing Bash can actually land the reflected rocket, aiming for Hicks. Can Hicks get a rocket off? Drama. Drama.
If I were Hicks, I would shoot the ground, sort of like, not the ground, the wall next to Bash, if you see what I'm saying, to try and get splash damage, because right now anything could kill him. But actually, Hicks doesn't know how much health Bash is to him. He could be 175.
I don't think any of them do. This is the thing. Unless they've really been calling out those numbers. Oh, wow.
It was too much of a mess there for them to get a proper idea of the health. So, to each of them, they're both at, you know, 100% health, you know, for all they know.
Oh, my God.
The most they can do is, like, assume that they're each on half health. Although Bash could switch to a shotgun and shoot him, and that
I don't know, because when you're a pyro, in pub, comp, whenever, and you get the first reflect off, you can work out the timing of when that soldier's going to hit the next rocket. So you can work out the timing to reflect it or get it away. So he just reflected one. It all depends on when Hicks is going to fire that. Hicks is in midair right now. Could he fire it straight now, or is he going to delay it? If he delays it, I'm not sure what the respawn times are. Am I analysing this fight? The hell?
Basically, lots of the Swedish. Oh my god! What?
Oh, they both jump forward! And we'll jump back! Okay, let's not scream like little girls. Let's not scream like little girls. I think Bash is gonna lose this, you know.
We do have Marth there in STV chat. He said that what's gonna happen is
Oh, he gets it!
Oh my god!
You were saying?
Oh my god! I was
wow.
About to... It doesn't matter now. That was amazing, Scully. I'm gonna retry because my heart is broken. But
you retry. Well, I just look at the fact that we've now got. It looks like it is Germans. They want to take this right now. They want to be aggressive. The Beeman goes down straight away. There's no chance of a backup. My heart's completely destroyed at the moment. And now the Germans have taken second. They want to go straight on now. There's it Stebersai who dropped. And I'm not exactly sure what's going on there. Anyway, enough about that. They're going to keep pushing on now, the Germans. They've got the advantage. They've got the momentum. They're going to keep going. They do capture the middle point. And are you back in now, Mir? Because I may want to do the same.
Yes, I am back in right now. And it looks like both Ubers are staying pretty even right now. You do have the Germans getting the point. And, it's currently, it's still on 3-1, like it was before halftime. And they're actually going for fourth right now. And is it being uncontested? You can see that the Swedes are sitting in lower lobby right now. There's not much you can do. Beaver there going down. There's a soldier up there. Gear there going in, taking down Hicks. Tuna's going down, being chased up by a Bash from behind. And Uber is popped in through mate. Surely this is a point to Germany.
It is. And that will make it 4-1. And Zebesai comes back. Yep, Zebesai's back, 4-1. This is the mid that will decide it for them. Here we go then. I'm not sure. Sweden should be able to win.
Yeah, I'm on the rib cam right now. He looks like he's doing an aggressive rollout. He's in the enemy choke at the moment. And you can see that lots of the German soldiers are actually in. Who's that putting so much pressure on rib? He's stuck underneath right now. Brigo there cleaning up rib after he catches a rocket to the face from a gear jumping in, gear going back in and cleaning up Beeman. I think that is a wipe for Sweden right now. Germany going forward on their momentum and being really dominant.
Call it a wipe. It's a wipe. Just too much aggression for Sweden to capitalize with. Bash actually hiding at the last. Yes, that's right. Bash is hiding at last. Has he been spotted? Yeah, he's been spotted. Okay, he's getting hunted down straight away. There's a bat being flown about. I'm not exactly sure what that's all about. They do take down Bash straight away, but now the Germans are going to be absolutely in aggression. They lose gear. They do have an Uber advantage. They want to use it, and they're going to use it straight now, but it's now completely ruined. Now they've lost it all. They're actually going to have to retreat right now. They're going to reset and recycle. They've not got the players up, as now they're going to have to go back, and this actually works in the Swedes' favor.
I don't know, that door is getting sticking up pretty hard there by Brago, but Beeman there going in into his face takes him down, Bash there going down as well. Surely Sweden can push out and get this point back, although it does look like, who is that? Is that Ips jumping up there? It's Gear, and it immediately gets shut down by Walters.
Yeah, they will capture this point right now, as now they will take that and they will start pushing the Swedes. It's been a weird game at the moment, but now they've got the momentum in their hands. Could they actually get around back? Gonna take Pocus down that one scout there. They are gonna take him down. There goes Sweden. They've got the advantage. They've got the Uber advantage. Well, they're gonna lose it very, very, very shortly when you look at it. It's gonna be 100 versus 90. They're gonna have to play the slow right now. They wanna go fast, but I'm not sure if that's the right thing to do. 24 minutes to get four captures. They're gonna have to make the force. Just survives there. Tunas with a great survival. Now they're gonna have to look at it. They lost Rib. It's gonna be a soldier versus the. Okay, yeah. Germany has a sharing, so it's gonna be soldier versus the scout and a demo man. And actually, the soldier wins. Well, no one wins. They both retreat.
Yes, but they don't have Rib there, and this will give some wiggle room for Germany to push in. Yeah, you can see they're capitalizing on that. Tunuts there, not so quick in saving his demo man. He probably should have popped earlier and known that both Ubers were even. Make a see Brago there, blocking off the Swedish choke at the moment. And there's not much he can do. Both Ubers are even coming up to 50% right now. And who's that going sniper? That is Walters on sniper.
Walters going sniper. We haven't talked about Walters a lot, but he is a beast of a sniper. People know how good he is, and if they don't call it quick enough, then that's it. He will get a kill before they even get a chance to call it. You can see the Germans, they're getting ready right now. They're preventing Sweden to push, because in some respect, the Germans know that they don't have to do anything. They'll just let Sweden go for the push. And you can see, that's what they want to try and do, Sweden. As now the Uber's up for fun, it's going to be up shortly for Tunat, and it looks like that Sweden actually wants to go for this. And just as I say that, they decide, you know what, we don't want to.
Yeah, they're gonna have to wait for Walters to do some sort of pick right now. Let's see where Walters is standing. He's standing by a big door at the moment, but actually going down to some great aggression from Zebeside. Uber's like changing, there's that odd little dance there. But I do believe the Swedish Uber was popped first, so they do have to back out earlier. And now they're surely gonna heal up and push back in with the number advantage.
Reset and recycle. Technically 5-on-5 if you count the Walters, the sniper. They do lose Zebeside straight away, and now goes his get straight away. They got focused into a corner. Good spam there from the German soldiers and the Dimmerman. And now it looks like Germany, they will turn on this aggression right now. This is what they want. Gonna go for the big door. And now bait down. Who's that soldier going for the bait there? It is it. Bates, and now comes Gear. Turns it around. No one's there. They're gonna go straight onto second right there. I like that. Just using their soldiers to scout it out. Hold people forward. And now they'll be able to get this straight on there. Walters down from the headshot. What can he do now? What can Bash do with another headshot? He's not going to get anything. In fact, Stefan goes down. Second is not captured for the Germans yet from that one little scout by the name of Beaven.
Yeah, you can see Rip there has actually timed out. So then it means that Zebeside has to switch over to Demoman at the moment, which he was experimenting with in a Season 16 preseason. But anyway, back onto the action. It looks like Germany are pushing all the way onto last right now. That Uber is popped. Ubers are exchanged at the moment. And they're doing their best, but there is a soldier in the water trying to get in. That is Ips. Two soldiers in the water. This is going to be very interesting to watch. That point's getting sticked up by Zebeside.
Yeah, they're onto the point right now. It's a times two, it's a times three. There's one soldier left. He doesn't take it out. He doesn't get taken out. And it is going to be the win for Germany. They win the first map. 4-5-2-1. That was right, wasn't it? 5-1.
Yes, it was. It was 5-1 to Germany there on Gully Wash.